So hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you guys are doing great. So in this video I'm going to show you how you can create this kind of light switching effect in the Blender with the help of the drivers. So without any further delay, now let's get started tutorial. And before starting the tutorial guys, I just want to tell you one thing. If you want to do practice on this project file, so you can download this project file from the description. That will be free for my all subscribers. So now let's start the tutorial. And one more time, I just want to show you what we are going to make exactly. So here you can see this is the off and this is the on. So how we can create this kind of light switch effect. So now let's start the tutorial. So first of all, I'm just going to cut this project file and start a new fresh file. So here you can see guys, here we have a new fresh file. So first of all, I'm just going to collapse this window something like that. And now I'm just going to show you what we have exactly. So here we have a basic scene here. Okay, so here we have a 1-point light. Here you can see this is nothing to explain you more. And same thing, we have a basic model of this switch. Okay, here you can see this is a very basic model. And we have a one chair here. Okay, so first of all we are going to make this switch up and down effect. So how we can create this basically, so here you can see guys, if I'm just going to move this switch pressing the Z, so here you can see it's going to everywhere. There is no particular direction of this switch. So how we can maintain this limit and how we can maintain the direction. So for that, what we have to do, we have to just press the N on our keyboard. And first of all, I'm just going to enable my shortcut VR, so you can easily see which key I'm pressing on the right hand side. Okay, on the right hand side you can see easily. So then I'm just going to my item section, and under the transform we have some location transform here. And if I'm just going to click this switch, so here you can see we have some locations values here. So right now if I'm going to move it, so here you can see it's going to everywhere. So how we can hold this position, basically how we can lock this position. So we'll just going to lock this X and Y. So here you can see our hub problem is solved. It's just going to move only a Z axis. That's great to us. Okay, but there is one problem also. If I'm just going to move this on a Z axis, it's going to beyond this shape which we have created here. That is we want. Okay, so for that, what we will do, we'll just add one constrainer here. It's called limit constrainer. So for that, I'm just going to make constrainers option, and here I'm just going to add one limit constrainer. It's called limit location basically. So here we have to add some minimum and maximum value of this slider. So first of all, I'm just going to add my minimum value of the Z limit from the Z axis basically, and then I'm just going to move it down something like that. Okay, and on the right hand side here you can see we have some value here. So I'm just going to press the C, and then I'm just going to paste this value to here pressing the V. So here you can see now it's not going to move beyond this shape, and that's great to us. Okay, so now I'm just going to move our second option. It's called maximum. So now I'm just going to click this Z. So when I click this Z, so it's going to here automatically move to here. So for that, what we have to do, we have to just uncheck this first of all. Then we have to just so first of all, I'm just going to move it upside and keep it where you want to stop it. So I think that's enough to me. Okay, then I'm just going to copy this value from here and going to paste it here, and then I'm just going to enable this Z value. So here you can see now if I just move it, it's not going to beyond this shape, and that's look great to me. Okay, but there is one problem. Here you can see if I'm just going to move this pressing the Z, so if I'm just reach it the end of this limit, but still our Z values going to increase continuously. Here you can see on the Z location transformation, if I'm just going to move it on the downside, so still these number are going to increasing. Okay, here you can see it's not going to beyond this, but these number are going to increasing continuously. So how we can stop this thing basically, how we can rid of this problem? So for that, we have to just enable our effect transform option. So what we will does exactly, it's not going to affect our location values after reach at the here. Okay, so here you can see now it's not going to affect any values of the Z location, and that's great. So that's how you can create this switch option here. So now I'm just going to move it to the other part. So first of all, I'm just going to select my light here. Okay, and if I'll just click this light properties, so here you can see we have our spotlight, and here we have some power of our light, okay, power of values. So what I'm going to do exactly, I'm just going to right click of this power value, then I'm just going to click the add driver. So when we'll click the add driver, we have a new dialog box appear here. Okay, so first one, I'm just going to change this scripted expression to the average value because we don't want to do any math. This is the very basic values here I'm going to put it. So here you can see it will look like this first of all, and then I'm just going to select my switch object. So this is our switch object basically. I'm just going to and then I'm just going to set this type as a Z location. Yeah, okay. So right now if I'm just trying to move it down this, so here you can see that will not going to affect our lighting basically. So it's going to affect it, but it's not too visible basically. So for that, what we have to do, we have to just first of all we have to just split this window something like that, then I'm just going to move it here. Okay, and then I'm just going to change our window as a driver window. Yeah, here you can see. And then I'm just going to select my light from the here. So here we'll see some graph here. Here you can see this is our graph basically. Okay, I'm going to move it. And then I'm just going to press the N. And after that, I'm just going to select our light. So when I click on it, so we will see this graph here. Okay, so first of all, I'm just going to change this as a driver. Okay, so here you can see we have the same setting which is we have done before. So I'm just going to switch to the F curve here, and here we'll see some options called interpolation option. So first of all, we'll change this interpolation to Bezier to the linear. Okay, and then I'm just going to put the value of this slider to here. Okay, and then I'm just going to change the value according to our light value. So first of all, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to select this here, and then I'm just going to copy this value and paste it to here. Okay, but make sure don't copy in a meter value because it's not going to accept this. So how you can copy this basically, so you have to just select it, and then you have to just select only these values. Okay, and then you have to just select your light again, and then go to the here, and on the keyframes option you have to just paste it these value. Okay, and then you have to just set the value as a 100. So our scene going to illuminate something like that. Okay, so you can increase this value to 100 as well. Okay, it's according to your scene illumination. Okay, so it's depend up to you how much light you want, but I think 200 is fine to me. Okay, then after that, what we will do, we'll just select this light again, and we'll just hit the home button, so we'll get this graph again. Okay, then I will select this bottom curve, just going to move it down something like that, and going to copy this same value from here except this M, and then I'm just going to select my light again and going to paste this value here. So here you can see what will happen exactly. So if I'll just move this slider to the upside, so our scene going to illuminate, and if I'm just going to downside, so our scene going to darker. Okay, so that is called basically on and off, and that's, so if I'm just going to collapse this window and going to again split this window and focus on this part and keep it here, so here you can see now I'm just going to off and on. So that's how you can create this on and off effect in the Blender with the help of the driver, and that is very easy and cool trick basically. You can try it anytime, anywhere, and that's it for this tutorial guys, and thanks for watching this video guys. If you learned something in this video, please hit the like button, hit the share button, and subscribe my channel. Also, if you have any queries, if you have any suggestion, please let me know in the comment box. I will definitely reply comment. So bye bye, take care and stay home guys.